Thank you for tuning into Spirit with me over the last season. It's been a pleasure serving you. We're going on a short break, but plan to be back with a new season. And we are still scheduling calls now, so sign up to join me on air at Radio Medium, lauralee.com. And remember, we're always available to you at Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and Twitter, too. Always love to hear from you. In the meantime, hope you enjoy one of my season's best. Have you ever received an unexpected sign that there's no denying it is a message from your dearly departed? Well, I'd like to welcome my special guest, Lynn, to share her personal experience. Welcome, Lynn.
Hello, Laura.
Thanks for coming on to the show. Can you share a little bit what happened to you the other day?
Well, it seemed like a little thing at the time, but then it evolved into a larger thing.
Mm-hmm.
I've been in the middle of moving my mother, who's going to be 94, to another assisted living apartment. And it was a lot of work, physical labor, and not to mention my mother's emotional labor. The move was hard on her.
Sure.
And the whole time, it probably was maybe 2 weeks long of moving and juxtaposing between buildings. And I felt my father's presence. He's been passed for about 12 years now.
Right.
And I kept feeling his presence with me and even got to be so close that I'd say jokingly, you know, what do you need, Dad? You know, or to myself.
Uh-huh.
And what is it that you want? You know, because he was such a presence then. I even feel him now that I'm talking about him.
Right.
But at any rate, nothing would come, of course, of that. And I ordered myself some earbuds. And when they came in, they were cheap and superficial. One fell apart. And then I remembered that I had some in my drawer that I found a year earlier.
Mm-hmm.
And looked scouting through the drawer, and I found them again. And I had asked all my grandchildren. I have seven grandchildren, and they all have iPads or iBuds. Is that what you call them?
AirBuds.
And I asked after all of them if they belonged to them. All of them had their own, and no, they hadn't lost any. And that brought us up to COVID. Well, the only ones that have been in this home have been some friends of ours before COVID, and that's it, no one else. So I knew I hadn't picked them up off the ground anywhere or anywhere other than in my house. They just appeared to me in the house about a year ago.
Mm-hmm.
And then I put them in a drawer, and I hadn't thought anything more of them except that I was looking for something the other day, and I came across them again. And I remembered that the other ones had broken, and I wondered if these would work. And I went and I plugged them in, charged them. And then when my granddaughter came over that evening, I said, hey, could you see if these work for me? And I had no idea how to pair them with my phone or anything. And she took them away, and a minute later, she hollered out to the kitchen, so who's Big Daddy? And we all sort of stood in our tracks staring at each other because the adults in the room knew who Big Daddy was. I mean, there's no doubt about it that Big Daddy was my father. That was all he was ever called from his friends. Everyone that knew him was Big Daddy.
Mm-hmm.
And the irony is that I had been feeling him so close. It was like he said, see, I was there. So, you know, he never would have bought for himself, even if they had been around. So that makes it even more incredible, I think. And they work perfectly, by the way. I'm enjoying them very much.
Well, wonderful. Well, I appreciate you sharing your story with our audience. And you believe now that it's a confirmation that he's...
I would say so. I don't know how else you could take that.
Right. How can you explain it?
Be in my house.
Right.
Way to explain it.
And who would actually put in the code Big Daddy?
Big Daddy. You know, maybe a worker or something mm-hmm. had come through, I thought, even, mm-hmm. and maybe lost them out of his pocket or something. But
right.
No, we had been, because my mother lived with me for a while, and right. my husband was very sick, and we didn't let anyone in this house.
Well, thank you for sharing your time with me.
My pleasure.
And if you have a spirit story you'd like to share with our listening audience, go to RadioMediumLauralee.com and submit your experience on my contact page with the subject header, Spirit Story. And you can also go to my Facebook, Radio Medium Lauralee Group, and submit your story there as well. As always, I'd love to hear from you.